Hi. Today you will learn the incredible story of a military pilot from the USSR. If you like the video, please like it and subscribe to our channel. On September 6, 1976, at 6:45 a.m., Soviet pilot instructor Viktor Belenko took off from Sokolovka airfield to perform a flight exercise. And at 9:15 a.m., Japanese radio reported that a MiG-25 plane piloted by a Soviet pilot landed at Hakodate Airport on the island of Hokkaido. The plane landed at the local airport, but the runway was too short for it. After leaving the airport strip, the fighter plowed through several tens of meters of soil before stopping at the far end of the airfield. The pilot got out of the cockpit, pulled out a gun and fired two warning shots into the air, scaring off drivers on the highway running along the airfield. It took several minutes before the airport representatives arrived at the landing site and then 29-year-old Lieutenant Viktor Belenko announced his intention to surrender. This was not the first flight by plane from the USSR, but one of the most insane. Because at that time, the MiG-25 was classified. In the United States, the existence of the MiG-25 first learned about the 70s. Reconnaissance satellites observing military airfields of the USSR discovered a new type of aircraft that looks like a giant fighter. It was known only from blurry images from space and from flashes on Israeli radars. They thought that the plane would remain a mysterious threat if they could not get a copy to study. In other words, if some Soviet military pilot does not try to escape with a combat vehicle. At first glance, Viktor Belenko was a model Soviet citizen, but he became disillusioned with Soviet reality. He had a wife and child, but the marriage was on the verge. The study of Belenko's personality, his behavior in the service and at home showed that he repeatedly developed acute conflict situations with the command. During his service in the Stavropol Aviation School, he expressed an insistent desire to leave the instructor's job and in this regard sought various opportunities for transfer to a combat regiment. But these attempts were not successful because the command, pilots instructors from the School of the Army did not let go. For this reason, he became discontented and sharply strained relations with the commanders. In 1975, he filed a report to the head of the school with a request to dismiss him from the Soviet Army, arguing that he did not want to serve with commanders who constantly abuse alcoholic beverages. As a result, Belenko realized that the new combat aircraft that he was training flying at the time could be his lucky ticket. The MiG-25 was a high-speed and high-altitude aircraft, but due to the high fuel consumption of the engines, its flight range was short. It was impossible to get to the nearest U.S. air base. On September 6, Belenko and his partner flew out to perform training management. Belenko had already drawn up a rough escape route. Taking advantage of a mechanic's error, Belenko refueled the plane's full tanks instead of the allowed half. He was motivated by the fact that he was flying a little longer and not to refuel twice during the flight. Belenko broke away from his partner, descended and sent the plane to the coast of Japan. It flew at an extremely low altitude above the sea, about 30 meters. To avoid being detected by radar. When the plane went deep enough into Japanese airspace, Belenko gained an altitude of 6,000 meters. Japanese air traffic controllers tried to contact him, but Belenko's radio station was tuned to the wrong frequency. Japanese fighters were alerted, but by that time Belenko had descended again, breaking through a thick layer of cloud and disappearing from radar screens. Belenko flew from memory, focusing on the maps that he studied before departure. His initial plans were to land at Chitose Air Base, but the fuel was running out and the pilot decided to land at the first airfield he saw. It turned out to be Hakodate. The Japanese side suddenly had to deal with a defector pilot complete with a top-secret combat vehicle. Hakodate Airport was filled with representatives of the intelligence services. The CIA could not believe such luck. The plane was disassembled and for several weeks carefully studied to get an idea of its technical characteristics. Belenko's partially assembled plane was loaded onto a ship and sent back to the Soviet Union. Japan issued a bill to Moscow for $40,000 for the transportation of the car and for the damage caused to the airfield. The Soviet Union did not pay this bill. Belenko did not return to the USSR. He was allowed to move to the United States. President Jimmy Carter personally approved the rendition of American citizenship to the defector. Belenko, having experience as a flight instructor, assumed to voice on the air for young Soviet pilots the coordinates of the nearest Japanese airfields and the algorithm of actions for them to circumvent the Soviet radar detection stations, as well as other practical recommendations and advice of the person who managed to escape, to encourage the hesitant to commit escape. But such mass participation went beyond the practical need of the United States for Soviet defectors, and Belenko was refused to record a radio message to the Soviet pilots. Belenko's escape was attributed to material damage to the Soviet Union in the amount of about 2 billion rubles. Because urgently it was necessary to change the equipment of the system of identification of your own someone else's across the country. In the system of launching missiles of the fighter, a button appeared that removed the lock on shooting at their aircraft. It was nicknamed Belenkovskaya. Subsequently, Belenko worked as an aerospace engineer and advised the U.S. Air Force. He died in 2006. Thank you for watching this video to the end. Subscribe to our channel and enable notifications about our videos so that you don't miss anything. See you in new videos.